Hey everyone, my name is Felipe Schmidt. In today's video, we're going to talk about the My Active Items widget in the Employee Center. So basically, we're going to deep dive a little bit how we can make use of it without any type of code so that we can call and use some functionalities directly from the index page in the Employee Center. So let's do it. So here is an example what we are going to deep dive a little bit. I'm impersonating a user in here. The user has some active items that we can use an example. And in here we have tasks, and then we have exactly those cards in here. These are going to be our focus today. And of course, we have also some requests, some surveys and stuff like this that we are also going to see how we can create those entries so that this can be available to the user. So our focus are going to be in three steps. First of all, how we can configure this card and how we can display those fields in here, like high, like planned start date, planned end date, short description. The second part is going to be how we can display, for example, tasks in here, requests, surveys. And the third step is going to be how we can create or hide those actions in here, like approve and reject. So let's start first how we can create those entries in here, like tasks, like requests and surveys. As I said, right now I'm impersonating a user. The user already has some records that we can directly see, but I'm going to use my user right now. So the admin user, so that you can see how it looks like. It looks like this. My admin user doesn't have anything. And basically, I can see all the necessary active items that are configured in the instance because I'm an admin in here. And whenever you go to the backend, you can deep dive and you can go and navigate directly to Employee Center. And here, the most important thing right now is going to be the activity configuration. Whenever you click in here, you're going to go to that table, and this table contains exactly, as you see, surveys, requests, tasks, GRC stuff, policy acknowledgements, etc. And if you compare to that, is exactly everything that you see in here. And that's how you can create new stuff. As you see, everything here is active. So if I want to make something inactive in here, I can simply come here. I'm in another scope, so that's why this year is another, it's a bad example how I can make it inactive, but maybe if I come here and I just set it to inactive, and then I go here, so I will have 1 point less. So now my GRC tasks, my GRC assessments are gone right now. I'm just going to make it active again so that we have everything in there, and we are going to come back here. That's how you can simply create those kind of lists that are going to be displayed in there. And as you see, in here you have some counters. And you also, whenever you click in here, you're going to be redirected to my request page. And whenever you see, for example, for tasks, you have the summary view script, in which if you put your mouse over it, it will say, script that return items count. So this script included in here is simply getting the count that is going to be appearing exactly in here. That's the most important thing to understand. So that's how you put that counter. The second step to understand is the list view script. And here is the script that is going to return the data. So basically, this is the template that the ServiceNow provides us out of the box so that you can have an idea which kind of information is going to be retrieven from there. We're going to reach that part in a few minutes, but basically what you need to understand here is that whenever you need to create a new entry to be appearing in this My Active Items, the only thing that you need to do is to come to Activity Configuration and configure your record from here. Now, the second step is going to be how we can add the information in the card itself. So, for example, in this kind of situation in here, in which we have a change request to be approved, what is the information that is going to appear in here? And that's how we come now with the to-dos configuration. In a to-dos configuration, we have some tabs in here, but this is not really what we're going to be interested in right now. The most important thing that we need to focus right now is that we're going to provide the possibility for the user as a requirement so that the user can perform some actions and see some cards in the index page. And for that situation, whenever we have an approval card, we're going to talk about approvals. And whenever you click in here, you see the approval configuration as well as the to-do configuration details. And in these details in here, you have some condition that is for change request. And whenever you click in here, you're going to see all the necessary information for the change request that is going to appear in that card here. So here, for example, I'm going to remove this action group so that you can see that we are going to have an issue. So I removed right now, and now I'm going to impersonate the user that I was impersonating before as an example, because this user has some stuff. And as you see, the approve and reject, it's gone, because right now I have removed that, and the only thing that I can perform is to simply view the details. So whenever I click in here, I'm going to be redirected directly to the to-do record itself. So I can go back, and now I can see that I don't have that action anymore. So I'm going to unimpersonate, and we are going to see that I need to add here, and here I can configure all the fields that are going to appear in there. So for example, I don't want the risk to appear in there. I want the active. I know that this doesn't make any sense, but I want the active to appear in there. So whenever I go here and I impersonate my user back so that we can see that working. Now we can see that this field here, true, it was previously the risk itself. It was high, medium, low. Now it's going to be true, active, true or false. So this is only to give you an example on how you can make use of it so that you can change how is the look and feel of your approval record. In this example here, the to-do configuration detail that we are doing is the change request itself. So in this detail is where we can, let's say you have a new kind of approval or a knowledge base article or something like this. You can simply come here and you can say that you want to use that source table, and your source table is going to retrieve some specific fields that you can display in there. In this case here, it's going to pick all the information from the change request itself, in which is the planned start date, planned end date, etc. And this is how you can display the fields in that card. And now the last part is how you can configure those fields to appear exactly as approve and reject, for example, in that part. And here is where it comes the action framework itself. And the action framework you can see directly from here. In here, you have approve, you have some out of the box ones. And you have mostly the most important ones are right now that we are talking about is the approval approver table, in which you have approve, reject, approve with comments, and reject with comments. This is what in that to-do configuration uses this group in here. So if we link everything together that we were speaking previously, the activity configuration that we speak in here, it will grab the task. The task shows the records in the air, shows the number, the counter, shows the records in there. And basically, based on that, we have the to-do's configuration details that we see all the fields, and the fields itself, they appear in this group. And the group itself contains exactly this part in here, the action framework. So if you see these action groups in here, it's exactly the approvals action group that is in here. So this is how they play around. I know it might be a little bit confusing, but you just need to understand that for each kind of record and for each kind of approval that you need to display there in the index page, you need to do some kind of configuration. So let's say there is a requirement in which the customer doesn't want approvers to approve something directly from the index page. The only thing that you need to do is you can have your card, you can keep it, but the thing that you can remove is simply the actions itself. The actions like approve and reject, you can hide it. So for example, you can remove this actions approval action group, or you can simply go to the actions table, like for example in here, and you can simply set everything to false. But here, of course, you have to pay attention, because if you are using different types of records, like for example, you are approving knowledge articles, you are approving requests, approving change requests, and all of those are using the same action group, then you have to be very careful, because this is going to deactivate all of them. So whenever you click in false, this is going to deactivate this card. So I'm going to impersonate back the user that I was using, and that, as you can see, I don't have the actions anymore. And then I can unimpersonate the user, and then I'm going to make it active again. I'm going to make sure that my action group is in here. I just need to do some, yeah, so basically it's in here. I have removed previously, and now I go to impersonate, look. Now I have my approve and reject actions here from the index page. So the key takeaways from this video are, whenever you need to perform some actions from the index page and you need to display in the My Active Items widget, you just need to focus first on the activity configuration so that you can display the tasks, for example, requests and service. Then you need to focus on the to-dos configuration detail for that type of record. So if you're talking about approvals, that you have a card for the approvals for change requests. So which fields are going to appear here in this card? And last but not least, you need to configure what are going to be the fields to be displayed in here. Of course, you can remove it so that anytime that you click, it's going to be view details. And when you click on the view details, you're going to be redirected to the record itself. I hope I could help. If you have any questions or any suggestions, please just use the comments below. Don't forget to smash the like and subscribe in the channel. Thank you very much, and see you next time.